Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Imran Wahid. Welcome to my channel Anatomy with Imran. Sometimes terms used in basic genetics seem to be confusing to us. Today we will be discussing some pair terms that convey a slightly different or opposite meaning to each other. Let's start. Let's first discuss what is gene. Gene is a part of DNA molecule that contains the nucleotide sequence. It is the physical and functional unit of heredity. It codes for proteins and regulates our physical and biochemical characters. Now, how many genes do we have in our entire genome? We have around 20,000 genes. We all know there are 46 chromosomes in our somatic cells, isn't it? Let's just focus on chromosome 1. Chromosome 1 contains over 3,000 genes. The position of a gene in the chromosome is called locus. Now, we should be knowing that scientists have identified association of many diseases with certain genes. For example, mutation in the PS2 causes Alzheimer's disease. Now, what is allele? We know we inherit one copy of gene from our father and one copy from our mother. For example, imagine these are the genes responsible for our eye color and hair color. So, we have got two versions of genes. The alternative forms or versions of a particular gene are called alleles. And you see, in the population, there are so many alternative forms. These are called alleles for that particular gene. We all are familiar with these two terms, aren't we? Let's do a matching and identify which criteria matches with the genotype and which with phenotype. First, version of a DNA sequence. Genotype, individual's observable trait. Phenotype, individual's collection of genes. Genotype, levels of hormones or blood cells. Phenotype, homozygous dominant. Genotype. So, we can say that genotype is the genetic makeup of an individual and phenotype is the observable traits. Let's talk about homozygosity and heterozygosity. This refers to the characters of the allele for a particular gene, whether they are same or they are different. Homozygous meaning same and heterozygous meaning different. Now let's find out which ones are homozygous and which are heterozygous. Capital B refers to type and small b refers to a different type. So first one, the same type, homozygous. Second one, different type, heterozygous. Third one, heterozygous. And the fourth one, homozygous. Let's move a little further and talk about the characters of gene. What is our general understanding? Dominant is the one which expresses and the recessive which doesn't. Let's consider capital D as dominant and small d as recessive. If you have a mutation in the dominant gene, what will happen? Wherever this dominant gene will be present, it will express and cause the disease. So, it will cause disease in homozygous and also in the heterozygous state. One example might be Huntington's disease. This person has got a progressively degenerating brain disorder. It is an autosomal dominant disorder. He has got a mutation in his dominant gene. Let's consider another case. The mutation is in the recessive gene. This gene will only express in the homozygous state. So, mutation in this gene will only cause disease if it is in the homozygous state. An example of this disorder is cystic fibrosis. It is an autosomal recessive disorder and the person has got mutation in both copies. In this disorder, the mucus becomes thick and sticky, so the patient gets persistent lung infection and it limits his breathing ability. Let's discuss our next pair terms. What is the total number of chromosomes in a normal somatic cell? Of course, it is 46. What if this number increases or decreases? A person might have 47 or 45 number of chromosomes. The condition of having this increased or decreased number of chromosomes is known as aneuploidy. This is a chromosomal picture of a male baby. Can you mark any abnormality? Yes, you are right. The baby has three copies of chromosome 21. This disorder is known as Down syndrome. The affected person has a distinct facial appearance, intellectual disability, and developmental delay. Now, what is polyploidy? Normally, in gamete, we have one set of chromosome, that is 23, and in somatic cell, we have two sets of chromosome, that is 46. But if it becomes more than two sets, like 3, 4, or 5 sets, then this condition is known as polyploidy. This is common in plants and also found in fish and amphibians. In human, having three sets of chromosome in his entire autism is not compatible with life. Let's move on to another pair of terms, gene expression and gene inactivation. What is gene expression? From DNA, by the process of transcription, RNA is produced, and by the process of translation, protein is produced. Ultimately, DNA instructions are getting converted into functional product, that is protein. By this, DNA regulates our physical and biochemical characters. Now, what is gene inactivation? In each cell, all genes are not expressed. Some of the genes are turned on and some are turned off. The phenomena of turning a gene off is known as gene inactivation. There are multiple mechanisms of gene inactivation. A classic example would be inactivation of entire X chromosome in females. Also, there are some imprinted genes. Sometimes they express if the origin is paternal, and sometimes they express if the origin is maternal. Inactivation of tumor suppressor gene leads to cancer. Our next pair terms are really very confusing. Someone having a genotype might not have the phenotypic expression. For example, mutation in BRCA1 causes breast cancer, but all the people having the BRCA1 mutation do not have breast cancer. The probability of expression is known as penetrance. So, how a genotype penetrates into its phenotypic expression, that is the penetrance. Now, what is expressivity? Look at the picture. Expression of pain due to needle prick differs from person to person. Someone cries out very loudly and someone might absorb it. The degree of expression is known as expressivity. For example, polydactyly is an autosomal dominant disorder. But some affected persons might have an extra digit in his all four limbs, and someone might have only at one limb. And the size of the extra digit also varies from person to person. Someone might have larger and someone might have smaller. So, due to a genotype, phenotypic expression may also vary. The degree of expression is known as the expressivity. Let's move on to our next pair terms, pleiotropy and genetic heterogeneity. One gene might be associated with multiple phenotypic expression. For example, mutation in a single gene that codes for phenylalanine hydroxylase leads to phenylketonuria. Due to the absence of the enzyme, phenylalanine cannot be converted into tyrosine. The person with phenylketonuria has multiple phenotypic expression like albinism, eczema, and neurological disorder. Due to defect in a single gene, multiphenotypic expression is occurring. This is known as pleiotropy. In contrast to that, defects in the multiple gene might lead to a single disorder. For example, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome is a connective tissue disorder caused by defects in the multiple genes. Therefore, phenotypic expression of a single disorder due to multiple genetic defect is known as genetic heterogeneity. Our next pair of terms are quite interesting. Let's first discuss mosaicism. When there is a mutation in a cell, all cells produced by that mutated cells by mitotic cell division are different from non-mutated cells. So, that person will be having a mosaic pattern with two different types of cells. This is known as mosaicism. One example is mosaic Down syndrome. All cells do not have trisomy. Some cells are normal and some are trisomic. Now, what is chimerism? Imagine that two different ova have been fertilized by two sperms and form two zygotes. They have produced two different cell lines and the genetic constitution is totally different. At some point, they might fuse with each other. Now, this individual is called diaspermic chimera. The difference from the mosaicism is it has originated from two separate zygotes. Another chimerism occurs in dizygotic twins. They exchange their cells through placental barrier. If their blood groups are different, it may happen that one twin possesses 90% of RBC of his blood group and remaining others from the blood group of other twin. So one single person is having RBC of two different blood groups. This is known as blood chimera. Now these are our last pair terms, mutation and polymorphism. It's your turn. Can you answer the following questions? Can you give an example of polymorphism? Is polymorphism natural? What is a point mutation? Please answer in the comment section. Thanks for listening. If you like this video, share it with your friends and please subscribe this channel to stay in touch.